was but a messenger of Allah and his word, which he directed to Mary.
So, look at this one, okay? This is the manuscripts in Uzbekistan. This is after Uthman.
Yeah, so where did...
Where are the dots? Which Quran are you reciting?
Quran, yeah.
Which Quran are you reciting today?
What do you mean, which Quran? There is only one Quran.
No, there are not one Quran.
There is only one Quran. Can you show me another one?
Yeah.
So are those attributes
the message that is
separate from him
Quran
or part of
is
him?
Internal.
So when it comes to Islam, that's a very big question. Are the attributes of Allah, 99 attributes of Allah, are they part of Allah or separated from Allah?
It's the message that is internal. It's not the paper. It's not the paper that you have. It's material.
No, no, no. We don't believe the same thing. We don't believe the same thing.
But the word itself is internal.
That's how men believe that. Because look at the church. She's not here to have a conversation.
So you've been talking to me for a while, and then
you're not going to talk about it.
From him and they are part of him. So if the attributes of Allah is part of him,
sorry, way before Quran. Way before. Yeah?
So if the attributes of Allah are not separated from him, it is part of him.
Which word?
Okay? So Allah is loving. That is his attributes from beginning to end. But there is a question, what was Allah loving before the creation? When it comes to the Quran, it is the same. Quran is identified by you as the eternal word of Allah. Is it separated from Allah or is it part of Allah?
And the word,
it's not separate from
Allah. So if Quran is not separated from Allah, why I just shoved it from my bag? I am holding some parts of Allah.
Because it's the written form. His word cannot... It's the word form of Allah's eternal word.
So, Quran is the word form version of Allah's eternal word. So, why does Allah, in his eternal word, needed to express itself?
Express what?
Needed to express itself.
For us to understand.
For you to understand, okay? So, I do hope that you are having some questions I am asking you, because your answers are not justifying me. But I want to read something to you. So you said, the word of Allah is part of Allah.
It's part of Allah, but it's not.
So, word of Allah. Separate. So if it is part of Allah, and if it is not separated from Allah, it is part of him. Okay? So, in here it is. All people of the scripture, do not commit excess in your religion or say, Allah accept the truth. The Messiah Jesus, the son of Mary, was but a messenger of Allah and his spirit and his word, which he did cast upon Mary and a spirit from him. Can you open your translation and then read it, your translation, and then explain it to me? Sorry, Afaz. Sorry, too much background noise. Do you mind to come close it a bit here?
It's a speech.
So, can you tell me, as it says, the word of Allah, which was cast into Mary, okay, in that time...
The word of God was cast into Mary.
Yeah, Surah 4, verse 171. Can you read it for me and then tell me? Surah 4, Surah Nisa, verse 171.
Oh, I'm already on that.
345. Can you read and tell me?
All people of the scripture, do not commit excess in your religion or say about Allah except the truth. The Messiah Jesus, the son of Mary, he was but a messenger of Allah and his word which he directed to Mary and a soul created at a command from him. So believe in Allah and his messengers and do not say three. Desist. It is better for you. Indeed, Allah is but one God. Exalted is he above having a son.
So can you explain it to me part where it says, okay, it is the word from Allah dictated to marry, Arabic is supposed to be saying cast out on to marry. Okay, in that time, as Jesus is the word of Allah, is Jesus separated from Allah?
No.
Like the Quran? It's Jesus separated from Allah, or is Jesus part of Allah like the Quran?
You know, in my belief, I believe Jesus is.
You are Sunni Muslim?
Shia.
Are you Sunni Muslim?
Shia.
You are Shia, okay. If you are Shia, you shouldn't be believing Quran is eternal.
Why not?
Shiites don't believe Quran. Anyway, it doesn't matter. Sunnis believe that. That's absolutely fine. Sorry.
So what I was about to say was that, as you said, that Jesus is the word or something.
Allah says that. Allah says the Messiah Jesus, son of Mary, was but a messenger of Allah. His word. Jesus is the word of Allah.
Okay, so yeah, I believe that Jesus is called Ruh Allah.
Jesus is the word of Allah as well as the spirit of Allah.
Yes.
Written next part as soul. Arabic word is actually the Ruh. So Arabic word is the soul.
Yeah.
So he's the word and the spirit. Yeah.
Yes. So now what was your question?
So my question was, as Jesus the word of Allah, so according to your criteria, Jesus is supposed to be part of Allah. So how come not only Quran comes into this world, okay, as the word of Allah, and then how come Jesus is born of woman as the word of God? So that's my question to you.
Could you say it again?
So, as a Muslim, you stated that word of Allah is part of Allah, not separated from Allah. So, Quran, as the word of Allah, steps into this world, and then we've got in book, okay? As well as Jesus, the word of Allah, cast into Mary, and become baby Jesus, and then adult Jesus. So how come that works?
So because as I believe that there is nothing like God. Yeah?
Yeah, that's Surah 42 verse 11, Surah 112. Yeah.
So what he said was that because I said be and it will be. So Jesus coming in the womb of Mary is not something that makes him so divine just because he was born to a virgin, but and as you said that he is the word of God.
So I never said Jesus is born of virgin, therefore he is divine. I never stated that. So I am grateful that you get the understanding of the Christian scripture, and then you think from the Christian scripture, Jesus is born of the Virgin, Emmanuel, God is with us. So that's very good process. But that's not what I'm asking you. The word of Allah, word of Allah cast into tummy of Mary. Okay? So you told me that word of Allah was part of Allah, like the Quran. So there is not, what is the difference between word of Allah as the Quran and word of Allah as Jesus? What is the difference?
The difference is that the Gospels, is a word of Allah. You believe that it's the word of Allah.
So I love to talk about the Gospels, but my question to you from the Quran. So with your criteria, so according to Islam, according to Shia, I haven't studied that much Shia sources because it's only Al-Kafi has been translated. That's all I read. So according to your book, Surah Nisa.
Oh, Nisa,
yeah. Surah 4, verse 171. So, according to your criteria, Quran is the word of Allah, and Jesus is the word of Allah. Okay. Have you got anything else in the Islam teaches someone else is the word of Allah, or something else is the word of Allah? Because it is only the Quran.
Let's get to the Arabic, can
you? Yeah, yeah. Get the Arabic. I've got the Arabic here as well. It is only Jesus. It is only Jesus and the Quran. Yeah. Difference between Jesus and the Quran is, Quran is eaten according to Sunni sources.
Eaten?
Yeah, according to Sunni sources, by a sheep. According to Sunni sources, okay? According to Shia sources, Quran is supposed to be 17,000 words. But Quran is eaten by a sheep versus Lord Jesus Christ is the one who says, I am the good shepherd. He is the one who, his sheep will listen his voice. So that's very, very much different. while Quran is being destroyed in the time of Uthman, Lord Jesus Christ gave himself for us, for humanity. That's the difference between the Quran as the eternal word of Allah. Sorry.
When you say distorted,
according to Sunni sources,
yeah. Now I know I've read about that matter somewhat, so I believe it's best to not talk upon it. But if you're saying, because of course I cannot say anything because of my lack of knowledge about the Quran being whatever. But this Uthman thing that you were talking about, it's not that he distorted it or he took anything out of it. It's just that, look, even to today, yeah, if you read the Quran, look, if you ignore all the things on top and underneath,
all the dots,
yeah, you still read it the same way.
No,
it will not affect it in any way.
Where are you from?
Pakistan.
Can you read and understand Arabic?
I can read it. I can understand a bit of it. But
okay. So, are you qualified to tell me if you get rid of the dots, it's gonna give you the same Quran?
Of course I can, because I don't need to look. If I read this word to you, let's say, okay, yeah, Rasul, yeah, it says Rasul. If I take all those, the ones that are on the top, there's a vowel here, yeah, which is called wow. That makes the soul. Do you get it?
So
Arabic wasn't written like this in the time then, before Uthman.
In the time of Uthman, they didn't have the dots. I agree with you.
No, not the dots. The line.
No. Vowels and the dots, like the letter, for example, ta, ba, those two dots. They didn't have that.
No, they did. It's just these other ones.
Abbas, they didn't. I'll show you the manuscripts. I'll show you the manuscripts. But until I find... Sorry, I need to get the internet. Until I find my manuscripts, okay? Can you tell me, because you expressed you are Shia, what is the Shia understanding of difference between the word of Allah as the Quran and word of Allah as Jesus? What is the difference?
There is no difference.
There is no difference.
I don't get what you're trying to say. The word of Allah, yeah.
Yeah, as the Quran.
Yeah.
You are telling me there is no difference. Quran to be the word of Allah as well as Jesus to be the word of Allah. They are the same.
No, that's not the same.
That's not the same. What is the difference?
So the difference here, as it said, let me just get it back up again. Was but a messenger of Allah and his word, which he directed to Mary.
So look at this one, yeah. Okay? This is the manuscripts in Uzbekistan. This is after Uthman.
Yeah, so
where are the dots?
Can you not see these dots? Can I not see the dot on the noon? Can I not see the dot?
They're not full. Are they fully full?
So, yes.
This is... No. Don't play that one. So this is dated, okay? Here's the date, 977. And dots are still forming itself, okay? Let me make it much easier. Do you know the date of the earliest manuscripts?
Really.
So this is the one in Tashkent. So this is much earlier than the one I showed you.
Okay.
Okay? Can you point out the dots to me?
But none of these letters here need a dot.
Just the whole page.
Let me have a look. Okay, yeah, the fire.
So they need the dots for you to understand. Okay? So can you be careful, please?
You can move forward, you know. That's
okay, yeah.
That doesn't mean you can kick me, sir. Watch out. He did. You are lying. Takia.
I'm lying.
Yeah, okay.
So it doesn't really have the dots. That okay, that's fine. Yeah. So at the time of Muhammad, they didn't have the dots. Okay? And as
they did have dots.
But dots are entering later. So in this one, this is 8th century manuscripts. It doesn't have the dots. Okay? And then the one I showed you from the 977, that one is having the dots, but it's not in its fully forms. So for in Arabic, consonantal letters, taba, all those ones needs a dot. Okay? The one you are talking on the tops, they are the tashkils. They are the vowels. Okay? So therefore, the reason I said the reason I said Uthman destroyed the Quran, because according to Sunni sources, that Uthman ordered everything to be burned.
Yeah, he did.
And then people like Umar, Caliph Umar, was saying actually there are the verses supposed to be in the Quran, but which we cannot find.
Yeah, you see this.
So that shows me that Quran has been corrupted. Therefore, when I was saying difference between Quran to be word of Allah and Jesus to be word of Allah, Jesus gave himself for us versus Muslim caliphs destroyed the Quran. That's the only reason I brought that up.
Okay.
So now let's go back to the original conversation. So what is the difference between Quran to be the eternal word of Allah?
He said, do not say it.
Quran itself is. Quran says, he is the finger, he is the word.
I have very little time, so can we?
Okay. What is the difference between Quran to be the eternal word of Allah as Jesus to be the eternal word of Allah according to Surah 4, verse 171? Since you told me, word of Allah is part of Allah.
So now, as you're saying that the Quran is corrupted, yeah, I'm saying it's not corrupted because it's been preserved through a chain, which I can tell you that chain as well. I can give you that chain.
Okay, can you give me the chain of Hafs?
Huh? The chain of what?
Can you give me the chain of Hafs?
The Hafs?
Hafs Quran. Which Quran are you reciting?
Quran, yeah.
Which Quran are you reciting today?
What do you mean which Quran? There is that, only one Quran.
No, there are not one Quran.
There is only one. Can you show me another one?
Yeah. This is Vorsh Quran.
Huh?
This is Vorsh Quran.
Okay.
The one was on your phone is Hafs Quran. Okay. This is Khalid's Quran. They are different from one another.
In what way?
The writings inside it, they are different. Okay, that's something we can be focused on. Just a moment. Just a moment.
It's okay, I've done it. I've done it.
Okay, you did. So there are differences inside them. Do you want to look at them now? Because you said you've got limited time.
Yeah, but let's just use.
Okay, is there a difference between Allah and Muhammad if you are using the word?
What do you mean?
Is there a difference between Allah, word Allah, and word Muhammad in Arabic?
Oh, of course there is.
Of course there is. Is there a difference in Arabic, I versus you?
In this scripture.
Yeah, they are different. Okay? So, in the Quran, if it says I am amazed, it is Allah. If it is saying you to the Prophet, that you are amazed, that is to Muhammad. Okay? So, here's the Quranic verse for you. Open your phone. Surah 37, verse 12. Surah 37, verse 12.
But you wonder why they mock.
Yeah. Read it again for me.
But you wonder why they mock.
So, you wonder why they are mock. Okay, so you to the Muhammad. Okay, in here, this is Khalid's Quran. In here, it says I instead of you wonder. In here, it's I. Check the Arabic.
Which verse is that?
Surah 37, verse 12.
Bal
So look at the Arabic words, okay? Arabic words are written differently. You can see? Look. It's here, this one. So you've got two dots. You've got two dots and then you've got line. Can you see?
Egypt.
Yeah. And then in one of them is I, in other one is you. So that's changed the full doctrine. Is it Allah amazed or is it Muhammad amazed? Okay? So that's just one of the examples. I can give you 93,000 differences. That's different topic. But okay. I'm still trying to understand. As you stated that Quran is the eternal word of Allah, it is the part of Allah, and then according to Surah 4 verse 171, Jesus is the eternal word of Allah. Jesus is the word from God which is cast into Mary.
All right.
So what is the difference between Allah, between Quran and Jesus?
Between Quran and Jesus?
Yeah.
So, have you ever looked into Surah Mubahalah?
Surah what? Give me the numbers. I'm better with Surah numbers instead of names.
Just to see.
Okay.
Give me the translation, I might know.
Oh, so call your sons, we'll call our sons, call your daughters, we'll call our daughters. And call your like and we'll call our likes. And we'll curse, we'll invoke a curse upon the liars, yeah, by supplicating.
So what is it has to do with what I'm asking?
So now Christians, two Christian priests, yeah, they came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they said that that Jesus is the word of God and Jesus is the son of God. So they challenged this fact, yeah? Now in the Quran, yeah, the Prophet said that we'll challenge you and we'll supplicate to Allah and invoke a curse upon the liars, yeah? So that they came, they invoked that curse. There's a whole
Abbas, my question is very, very simple. You believe Quran is the eternal word of Allah, okay? And Quran also states that Jesus is the word of Allah, which cast into Mary. So my question is very simple.
But where does the...
If the word of Allah steps into the tummy of Mary, and then Mary gives birth, that means something.
Okay, but so, God has spoken his word through Jesus. That's what you're not trying to...
But it's verse doesn't say that. Huh? Verse doesn't say that. Verse identifies Jesus as the word of God, word from God, yes, cast into... So you are not word of Allah, are you? So Jesus is the only word of Allah alongside of Quran. Alongside of Quran. Who is the other one? Huh? Who is the another being identified as the word of Allah?
Well, I can say many things, but don't worry about that. But Jesus is not the only word of Allah.
Who is the other one? Who is the other one?
Muhammad is the name, is the word of Allah.
So Muhammad, where is it that Muhammad is identified as the word of Allah? There is nowhere Muhammad is identified as the word of Allah. Muhammad gives birth to the word of Allah, but Jesus himself is the word of Allah, as well as Quran is identified word of Allah, according to Islam. So let me make my point. I know you got it wrong, but let me make my point. According to Christian scripture, okay, so Islam has lots of things to understand. Islam needs to understand how come while Allah is one, yet he has got these attributes are separated from him or part of him, which doesn't make that much sense at all. Islam needs to explain to the humanity how come while Allah is one and only, there is nothing Allah, yet his word steps into the world and eaten by a sheep. Islam needs to explain how
eaten
come...
By a sheep?
Yes, according to Sunni sources. You didn't know the adult breastfeeding verse? Is it adult breastfeeding verse, which is eaten by a sheep? Aisha testifies that. I know Muslims sees Aisha is a liar. She sees Aisha is a liar, but according to Sunni sources. So, Islam needs to explain that. Also, Islam needs to explain Jesus is identified as the word of Allah. So you've got no explanation to me, and then you said there are not much difference between Quran to be the word of Allah and Jesus to be the word of Allah. And let me bring it something to your attention, because that's how the conversation started. Yeah. Yeah, Jesus is the word of Allah. But yeah, who else? No one else.
When it says, when it was mentioned, the word of Allah is talking about the scripture which was given to Isa through him.
It doesn't say that, because it identifies...
I know it doesn't say that, but
in
Surah,
no. Like, are you trying... Abbas, how old are you? Are you trying to tell me? It is... So, no. Because, listen this carefully. You are trying to tell me, actually, Allah... failed with his communication skills. Allah meant something else. Allah didn't. Allah meant something else, and that's not the verse says. Therefore, I am gonna unpack what Allah is saying. That's the problem.
You know, in the Bible, the verse about the word is God, the word was with God, and so on. Where does
that's
it
what
say
I was going to come to that.
That Jesus is the word of God.
Yeah, let me come to that one. That's fine, I'll put it out. So, let me I'm grateful that you brought it up, because it's going to give you the reason why the word of God becomes human and makes his dwelling among us, okay? So John chapter 1, read with me. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through him, all things were made. Without him, nothing was made that has been made. Through Word of God, everything has been made. Everything. Okay? In him was life, and that life was light of man. The light shines into the darkness, and the darkness has not understood it. Let me come to that. The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of only begotten, who come from the Father, full of grace and truth. Okay?
It's not Shay.
So,
say no more. We're done.
Just be careful. They are Sunnis. Just be careful.
Don't worry, girls.
If you wanna walk away, that's absolutely fine, because you identified yourself as Shia and they are Sunnis. They don't get on well with it.
I don't care.
Okay, that's fine. So in here,
Sunni, I don't care, bro. We're all brothers in faith.
They don't think that's absolutely fine. Okay, that's absolutely fine. So in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and Word was God.
Okay.
And then everything was created by the word of God.
All right.
Okay? So, and you know someone called Abraham?
Abraham, yeah.
Yeah. Okay. So in here...
You got a lot of notes in there. You're rich.
My heart is rich. Lord Jesus Christ gave himself for me. So, I want to read to you conversation is taking place between Abraham, okay? After this, the word of Lord came to Abraham in a vision. Do not be afraid, Abraham. I am your shield. I am your shield.
Okay.
Your very great reward. But Abraham said, O sovereign Lord, what can you give me since I remain childless? And the one who will inherit my state is Eliezer of Damascus. And Abraham said, You have given me no children. So a servant in my household will be my heir. Listen this part very carefully. Then the word of Lord came to him. This man will not be your heir, but a son coming from your own body will be your heir. He took him outside and said, so word of God is talking to Abraham and then taking Abraham outside. Okay, so far? He took him outside and said, look up the heavens and count the stars. If indeed you can count them, then he said to him, so shall your offspring be. Abraham believed the Lord, and he credited to him as righteous. He said to him, I am the Lord. So, who is speaking to Abraham?
God speaking to Abraham.
So God is speaking to Abraham, but God is saying, I am the word of God, and I am the Lord.
Okay, yeah,
cool. Okay? Okay? And then we read in John chapter 1, okay? It's not only like speaking, taking, word of Lord is taking Abraham outside, talking to him, making promises, and then taking him outside, and then says, I am the Lord. You come to John chapter 1, which we read. In case like...
So you're too rich, man, sorry.
No, in case like something goes wrong, like I lost my things, okay? And then you come here, and then it says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. The world became flesh and made his dwelling us. So the Word of God, which Abraham came and spoke, came to Abraham and... So you do not reject this. So according to this, then the word of God is law.
It's just that you need to understand. I think you need to research more Shia perspective. You get me?
I do.
By doing that, you will understand my position.
So, in that case, am I right to understand that you believe as Jesus, the eternal word of God, who come and dwelled among us? Okay. So, also do you believe as the eternal word of God, Jesus, who came and dwelled among us, he says to the people, I give eternal life, I am the life, I am the resurrection, and that eternal word of God died on the cross by crucifixion. Do you believe that?
Died on the cross
by no, crucifixion. You don't believe that? Why don't you believe that?
Because I believe that at the right time, God picked him up, elevated him to the fourth sky, and Judas was killed instead of it.
Where did you get that information? Huh? Where did you get that information?
This is different.
Can you give me one? Can you give me reference?
Right now.
Because I looked at the Islamic teachings, and I didn't come across with that story.
Okay. Yeah. Where did you try to find this?
Surah 4, verse 157.
Surah 4, yeah.
Verse 157.
Muhammad is not coming back. Muhammad is not going to judge people.
So you believe Jesus is the word of God, okay? And then as a Christian, when we look at our scripture, we get to see everyone is going to...
Surah 4, yeah?
Surah 4, verse 157.
I'm telling you, according to your understanding, according to Islamic understanding, understanding.
After this, we'll just wrap up and I need to go because I'm literally...
Are you part of the demonstration?
Yeah.
Okay, can you come back after the demonstration?
Yeah, no
problem. Okay, check that out. And then show me where does it say it's Judas.
And for the no, but the, that bit you're gonna find only in different sources of history. If you get what I mean. And for their saying, indeed we have.
Okay, that will be different topic. Let me make a point on the word of God. Okay, since you both of us agreed that the word of God, Lord Jesus Christ, is eternal, who came and then made his dwelling among us, in the scripture it tells us. Okay. He is dressed in the robe, dipped in blood, and his name is the word of God.
Okay.
His armies of heaven were following him, riding on a white horses and dressed in fine linen. And then it goes on, and then talks about how everyone is worshipping in heaven to the word of God. Okay. Everyone, okay, remember, in John he created everything and everyone. Now, in heaven, everyone is worshipping the word of God. So, right, for me, we both agreed, I'm taking it as like, we both agreed there is not only something in the word of God, but there is something in Jesus forces me to think Jesus is not just a something, but he is the divine word of God who came and then made his dwelling among us, and one day everyone will worship him in heaven.
That's fine.
If you are saying that's fine, Abbas, that means you've got to do something about it. What are you going
to
do about it?
All I'm saying to you is that in the Gospels, accounts about Jesus' lifetime, the last bit of his lifetime, and when he was imprisoned by the Romans.
He wasn't imprisoned by Romans. He got arrested.
He got arrested. That's what I mean.
Yeah.
It differs. And now in Hebrew...
What do you mean it differs?
Huh?
What do you mean it differs?
The count differs.
What do you mean?
The count.
What do you mean? Give me an example.
Some said
so
that...
So is there any writing?
We saw our father... we saw the Son of God being raised by our Father to the sky.
I haven't read that in the Bible.
All right. I'm not sure, but... You probably know better about the Bible.
You are Shia Muslim. I'm Christian, okay?
Yeah.
One thing is very important that... One of the things both of us agree, we do have respect to our scripture. You have respect to your scripture, I have respect to my scripture. And my scripture overrides everything, okay? So, therefore, can I encourage you to please don't edit it into my scripture and do not destroy my scripture? So, there is no verse gives you such a statement.
If you have read the Gospels in Hebrew...
I read the Bible once a month minimum. Okay. And Gospels are written originally in Greek, not in Hebrew.
Huh?
Gospels are written in Greek, not in Hebrew.
Okay, yeah, maybe. So, but are you familiar with this this verse in the Bible where it says, it's in Hebrew, Eli, Eli, lema shabachthani.
What does that mean?
It means, oh Father, something, oh Father, help me, help me.
No.
You don't.
My God, why have you forsaken me?
Huh?
My God, why have you forsaken me? That's the one.
No, I know.
So, what is the problem with that? No, that's the verse you are talking about.
What, Eli, Eli, lema
shabachthani? Yeah, so that's the translation. I give you the translation. So, my God, why have you forsaken me? So, what is your problem with that?
No, nothing. I just wanted to know.
So, you wanted to know what? Do you know where is Jesus saying that?
Where?
Do you know?
No.
You don't know. Do you know where is Jesus giving us that quotation from?
Where?
Do you know that? No. So, you just gave me a verse. You don't even know the context.
I'm asking you.
Okay. So, where did you hear that verse anyway? Clearly, you never read it. Okay. So, probably people were just teaching you Jesus cannot be God.
No, no. Listen. I'm trying to take accounts from everyone. Yeah.
Yeah. You can't take it from everyone. You take everything and then you go check it out.
Yes, so, that's what I'm trying to do.
Jesus is stating that when he's in the Garden of Gethsemane, okay? That is before he goes to the crucifixion. If you are Muslim, by default, you don't believe Jesus died on the cross by crucifixion, okay? So, Jesus is giving us quotation from Psalm 22, which is pointing people to the Messiah who is going to pierce on the cross for the sin of humanity.
Can we just wrap this up?
That's all my part. So, according to Christian scripture, Jesus is the eternal word of God, and you agreed with me, and eternal word of God deserves our worship, sir. And then come back to me when your protest finishes. Okay, see you.
And the final words, what happened there? That was a long chat, wasn't it?
It wasn't that long chat. We talked about Muslims are a bit kind of divided regarding if the Quran is eternal word of Allah or not eternal word of Allah. Muslims are divided little bit if the Quran is the eternal word of Allah, separated from Allah or part of Allah. That's a big division is going on still. But we come to the conclusion, actually he came to the conclusion that word of Allah is part of Allah. Then I asked the question, how come part of Allah becomes a book and then eaten by sheep? Shia Muslim didn't know that much about that. And then I asked the question, so if the word of Allah is part of Allah, then can you please explain me who Jesus is according to Islam? Surah 4 verse 171 identifies Jesus as the word of Allah cast into the tummy of Mary. So word of Allah comes and then steps into the humanity according to Islam. And since they don't have the right Isa, in Christianity it is made very clear that word of Lord Jesus Christ stepped into the world, made his dwelling among us, lived among us, gave himself on the cross for us, and through him and with him and only with him, we are offered placed in the bosom of the Father. And one day everyone will bow down and worship the eternal word of God, Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.